Hi, it's only a matter of time before you encounter a use case when you have to create Angular components dynamically at runtime. In this video, we will take a relatively complex component that has inputs, outputs, and content projection, and I will show you how you can create and destroy this component, and also you will see how to change properly inputs for this component, how to react to the component outputs, and how to project content. And everything we will do by using the modern signal-based API. If it is your first time on my channel, my name is Dmytro Mrzhensky, and my goal is to help you to become advanced Angular developers. And on my channel, I share a lot of free, unique, and advanced Angular tutorials, and also I create video courses that you can check out later.
But now, let's focus on how to create Angular components dynamically.
All right, so let's dive in and figure out how we can create components dynamically in Angular. Well, to do this, we need two things. We need to know what we want to create, so some component, and we want to have some certain view container where this component will be created. The first part is pretty straightforward. This is just a class constructor of the component you want to create. However, the view container, this is something that a little bit more complex. Think of it as some box or container that can be created next to any DOM element in the template. And inside this container, you simply put different views that have to be rendered on the page. You can create your own containers, or you can reuse the ones Angular created automatically. For example, every component has its own view container, and you can get a reference to it by simply injecting the view container using the dependency injection. This ViewContainerRef class, it gives you various APIs to manipulate the views inside the container. For example, you can create embedded views from ng templates here, or you can create the entire component. And this is exactly what I need in my case. All this method requires is the class constructor of the component you want to dynamically create. Or let's maybe do it even in one line to save space. And that's actually the minimal setup to make it work. Now, when you click the Create Component button, the widget component is dynamically created and added next to the app root component. And the location where this component is created might be surprising a little bit, so let me explain. Well, by default, when you create a new component or embedded view inside the view container, the new view gets added to the end of the container. So because I'm reusing the view container ref that was created for the app root component, the view of this newly created widget component will be added at the end, making it appear after the view of the app component and not inside it. However, most probably you would like to specify explicitly the location in the template where this new component has to be created. And for that, we need to create our own view container. And this is pretty easy to do, actually. First, you need an element that will act as an anchor. This can be any DOM element, or you can use ng container construct if you don't want to create the extra DOM element. And after that, you can declare a template variable, a name there that will be used inside the viewChild function as an argument. And at this point, the variable is referencing to the DOM element, and to specify that we need actually the view container and not the reference to the DOM element, we need to define in the config object that we are requesting, or we are reading, the view container ref token. And once we configure it like that, then at runtime, Angular will create a new view container ref instance, and this new instance of the view container will be attached to the element that we used as an anchor. All right. So, and now since view child returns a signal, we need to also add parentheses right here and we're good to go. So if I try to create a widget right now, you can see that it is created in the correct place inside the component template. And it happened right next to the anchor. Okay. Another thing to note is that if you call create component with the same class constructor again, the previous component instance will not be destroyed and you will end up with multiple widget component instances. Okay, but what if you need to destroy the dynamically created component at some time? Well, there are a few ways to do this. The first option is to use the API provided by the component ref instance that is create component method actually returns. You can save the reference to the component ref in the component property or variable, and you can simply call the destroy method whenever you need to remove this dynamically created component. So now if I click the destroy component button, the component is removed, which is exactly what I need. However, since we are only keeping the reference to the last component ref instance, the previously created widget component will not be destroyed. And this is where you can use another API that is provided by ViewContainer ref. And I'm talking here about the method called clear that allows you to remove everything from the particular view container. So now if I create multiple components, I can remove them all just in one click. Also, you can remove a specific view from the view container by using the remove method. And there you can provide the index of the view that has to be removed. So if I save this change, you can see that when I click the remove component button, there will be removed only the component view of which one has index 1 and others were not affected. But in my case, it doesn't make too much sense to use this API, so I will revert it back to using the clear method. And also, I would like to call this method right before I create widget component in order to avoid having the multiple instances. Great. Now, you might have noticed that the widget title and subtitle, they're just placeholder strings right now. This is because that the actual title and description should be configured through the corresponding component inputs. But how can we update component inputs in dynamically created component? Well, to do that, you can use the component ref method again, but this time you have to call method setInput. And there you have to provide two arguments. The first one is a string which represents the name of the input, and the second one, it's the value for this input. And now let's do also the same for the second input. Then we can save it and now let's test the result. And as you can see, right now inputs have been successfully updated. Sometimes you might see that inputs are being updated using the reference to the component class instance. So you would see something like that if you use the decorator-based inputs. But this is incorrect and you should never do it this way. Always use the setInput method because it is a unified API that works with both type of inputs and more importantly, it behaves the same way as if the input was updated through normal input binding. And last but not least, the setInput method also respects the input aliasing. The only downside of the setInput method you should keep in mind is that it is not type safe. Maybe in the future it will be improved, but for now, please make sure that you provide proper types for your inputs via this method. Good. Now, let's talk about outputs. For example, this widget emits an event when the user clicks the close button. But how can I react to this event? Well, to handle this, you need to access the component instance and the emitter property. From there, you can subscribe to it and provide a callback function that will be executed when the event is actually emitted. For example, we could, well, maybe destroy the component, right? So if I save this change and then I will go to the browser and click the close button, the widget is destroyed. And by the way, according to the Angular documentation, if you are using the signal-based output, you don't need to worry about unsubscribing here. Angular will handle everything automatically when the corresponding component is destroyed. Also, unlike decorator-based outputs, these subscriptions have nothing to do with RxJS at all. Even though the API looks similar, this is a different story. The similar API was introduced just to simplify the migration from old event emitters to the signal-based one. And also keep in mind that signal-based outputs, they are still in development preview, so the API might change in the future. All right, now let's move forward and get into more advanced Angular topics and talk about content projection with dynamic components. If you are not familiar with content projection, I have a very detailed video about this, so feel free to check this out. The hint will appear somewhere in the top right corner. But in short, content projection allows you to project a certain HTML DOM nodes into the specific slots within a component, making it more configurable and reusable. And right now, we are not projecting anything inside our widget component, which is why we see those placeholders. But let's imagine that we have a component that we can define anywhere in the app root component template, and we want to project this component into the dynamically created widget. Well, the projected content should be configured when the component is created. And this can be done by providing a config object to the create component method, and there we can define the projectable nodes property. The value there should be an array of node arrays, where each node might be a simple HTML element. But, well, where and how can we get them? Well, there are many, many ways how you can do that. You can create those DOM nodes, or you can take already existing ones. And in our case, the easiest way would be to use the ViewChild functions again and get the reference to the component that we want to actually project. And like we did it with the ViewContainer, we want to explicitly specify that we actually need a reference to the component element and not to the component class instance, like it would be resolved by default. And after that, I can go to the projectable nodes and I can create an array that contains the native element of my weather content component. And once I save this change, you will see that when I create the component, the weather content is projected right inside the main slot of the widget component, which is really, really cool. However, despite it was the easiest way to demonstrate the content projection, this use case is quite rare when you have already rendered component and you have to project it into dynamically created one. In most cases, you most probably want to delay the creation of the projected content until the actual widget component is created, right? And for that, you could wrap the content that has to be projected in the ng template, making it, so to say, lazier. And then you would need to explicitly create the view from this template at some point in time when you need it. And for that, we would need to define again the template variable for this ng template. Then we can reference this template inside our component class via, again, ViewChild function. And here we can adjust the type of it because it has changed. So it will be the template ref of type, let's say, undefined. And I think we are ready to proceed. So having the reference to the template, we can now activate this template and create a view from it by using the, again, ViewContainer ref, but this time we'll be using the method create embedded view method. And there I simply pass the template ref as an argument for this method. After this, the embedded view will be created from the template, and it has also the property called root nodes. And this property contains the element node of the view that was just created and the view I want to actually project. And because it is an array of DOM nodes, I can remove this wrapper array I created before. And now we can save and test our change. So right now you can see that the widget content isn't rendered at all until I click the create button. Once I click it, everything has been created and projected exactly as we expected. All right, so we have covered quite a lot about the dynamic components in Angular. However, there are a lot more things to explore. For example, what if our widget component has multiple slots and how to insert content into a specific slot? Or another big question about the dependency injections, how to dynamically configure providers for dynamic components, and many other things. I will be diving all these topics in my private video that will be available on my Patreon, which I'm currently officially launching. And there, for the paid subscribers, I will be publishing different videos where I will be going more in depth and explore very specific Angular APIs, starting with the API that is related to the topic of this video. I also recommend you subscribing to my channel, because the next video will be about ng component outlet, which is also about dynamically created components, but the declarative way. It is more cleaner, but it has its own nuances. And of course, follow me on my other social media and join our Discord server, where you can get connected with more than already 500 Angular developers around the world. You can get connected with them, ask your questions, you can get answers, and just have fun there. Otherwise, thanks for watching this video until the end. I wish you a productive week ahead. Stay safe and see you in the next video.